Hello everyone, my name is Anshul Jain, Assistant Professor in the Department of Civil Engineering, SIRT College, Bhopal. In the last video, we discussed about some of the concepts of the latitude and departure. Today we are going to proceed with the same concept and looking into the further details of latitude and departure. So we came across the definition or the terminologies of latitude and departure of any line. So we have represented in the form of a triangular shaped field on the x and y axis, showing the various directions, that is north, east, south and west. So we came across the terminologies that northing and southing, easting and westing, these four directions are actually representing the latitude and departures. So in terms of northing and southing, we took latitude as positive and negative respectively. Same is the case with the easting and the westing. We took it as positive and negative in the case of departure. And this was the schematic diagram which is showing the latitude and the departure to all of us. This table shows us the table giving us the values of latitude and departure in terms of the reduced bearings. Here we are representing it in a triangular, in a quadrilateral shaped field. So the sides or the lines AB, BC, CD, and DA are having a length of L, and they are having the reduced bearings in these terms, which has been explained to us. The latitude and departure corresponding values are shown in the table as plus L cos theta plus L sin theta, whereas in the case of line BC, it will be minus L cos theta and plus L sin theta respectively. Same is the case, we have represented that for a closed traverse, the algebraic sum must be equal to zero. That is, the summation of all the latitudes and summation of all the departures combines to be zero. This is the case. As well as for a closed traverse, there is a cross-checking that the summation of all the northings and the summation of all the southings are both equal. Same is the case with the summation of eastings and summation of westings. The summation of both these values is always the same. So these are the standard tables which are showing us the values for a quadrilateral shaped field represented in the form of closed traverse. Then we discussed about various errors which are occurring in the theodolite and creating problems in finding out the values. Then we discussed about how to rectify this closing error in the case of a theodolite. With the help of latitude and departure values, we can find out the closing error and rectify it. Same is the case with the relative closing error and permissible angular error. These three values can be found out with the help of the latitude and departure summations. The angle theta, that is the direction of closing error, will be represented by 10 theta, and that will give us in the terms of summation of departure and summation of latitude. Then we discussed about some of the other terminologies related to this kind of traversing. But now we are going to discuss about the Bowditch rule, that is the balancing of the traverse, in this video lecture specifically. So beginning with it, now we are going to apply some corrections in the form of latitude of all the sides which are available to us. In terms of corrections, if we are applying, then to the latitude, we have the length of that particular side in the closed traverse when we will divide it by the perimeter of that entire traverse. That is, the summation of all the side of the traverse will give us the perimeter. So on dividing the length of that particular side with the perimeter of the traverse, we will multiply it with the total error we are getting in terms of latitude. That will give us the correction to latitude of any particular side. Same is the case if we need to find out the correction to departure of any particular side. Then the formula is, take the length of that particular side of the traverse and divide it by the perimeter of the traverse which is available in the form of the given field. And when we multiply it with the total error of the departure, we will get the correction to that particular departure of any one particular side. This is the Bowditch rule. Another is the transit rule, which says that in order to apply correction to the latitude of any particular side, you have to take the latitude of that side, the value of latitude, divided by the summation of all the values of the latitude. That is, the sum of all the values of latitude, and multiply it with the total error of your latitude calculations. That will give you the corrections of latitude to any particular site. Then second case says that if you want to apply correction to the departure of any particular site, then you need to take the departure of that particular site and divide it by the summation of all the departures, the values of all the departure, and multiply it with the total errors in the departure. These values can be corrected, and in this way we can find out the corrections to the latitude and departure. These are two different rules, Bowditch rule and the transit rule, which is giving us this value. Now the third rule says that if you are going to apply corrections to the northing, southing, easting and westing of any particular site in a theodolite, then you need to follow the following formulas. I would ask all of you to kindly note down the formulas very precisely, because there may be some corrections related to the southing, easting, northing and westing directions, but we need to be very much clear where to apply the formula in terms of latitude and where to apply in terms of the departure. So beginning with the formulas, if we are going to make corrections to the northing of any particular site, then the northing of that site will be taken along with the ratio of some of the northings available with us, multiplied with half times the error occurring in terms of latitude. Remember, half times the total error occurring in terms of latitude. That will give us the corrections to the northing of any particular site. Then we have corrections to the southing. So same case, we are going to divide the southing of that particular side of the traverse with the sum of the southings available, and we will multiply it with half the total error occurring in terms of latitude again. That will give us the value of corrections applied to the southing of any site. Now C part, that is third, is the corrections we are going to apply for the easting of any particular site. So the easting of that site will be taken, divided by the sum of eastings of all the sides of the traverse, and we'll multiply it with half times the total error occurring in the departure. In this way, we can find out the error in terms of easting that can be rectified, and this is called the corrections to the easting of that particular site. Last is the case of corrections we are going to apply to the westing of any particular site. So we should remember this, that we are going to take the westing of that site, we'll divide it by the sum of the westings available, multiplied with half times the total error occurring in departure. If the error, this is important to know, that if the error is positive, then correction will be negative. This is the opposite case we have to apply every time. If the error is positive, then corrections will be taken as negative, and vice versa. That is, if the errors are negative, then the correction you will make will be positive. So we must be very much clear that in terms of correction applied to the northing and southing for any particular site, we are going to multiply it with the total errors occurring in latitude. But if we are going to apply the corrections to the easting and westing of any site, then we are going to multiply it with the value of total error occurring in departure. This is actually a case of confusion which arises when we are solving the numericals. So this must be very much clear. I hope you all would have seen to these formulas and noted down it very sincerely. And the same case of balancing of traverse need to be also highlighted and learnt very sincerely. That how do we make the corrections to the latitude of any site or departure of any site in case of Bowditch rule or the transit rule. So I've explained you all the formulas here very easily. And in the upcoming videos, actually we are going to discuss about the numerical based on these method. We are going to solve a given condition, a given parameter that we are going to solve with the help of these formulas. So till then, I hope all of you would revise the concepts of this latitude and departure. It should be very much clear to you, because it is an important part of surveying which we have discussed in the videos. I hope all of you would have understood it. So I hope all of you would enjoy the next upcoming video that will be based on the numericals of latitude and departure. Till then, I would request all of you to stay healthy, stay safe, and stay at home. Enjoy the classes and keep on learning for the future endeavors. So thank you so much. This was it for the particular video. We'll meet again in the next video. Thank you, everyone.